Hello students of class 10th, how are you? I hope you all are fine. So dear students, let us continue with chapter 7, Glimpses of India. As this chapter has 3 parts, we have finished part 1, A Baker from Goa. We also have finished part 2, Coorg. Now we are reading Part 3, Tea from Assam, written by Arup Kumar Datta. As of now, what we have seen in Part 3? Part 3 starts with introduction of Pranjol and Rajveer. Pranjol is a boy who lives in Delhi, but he is from Assam. Rajveer is his classmates. Rajveer and Pranjol, they study in the same school and same class. Rajveer is from Delhi. Rajveer is invited by Pranjol to visit Assam during his summer vacation. So that is why Rajveer and Pranjol, they are going Assam by train. They are in the train. Train stops at a station. Then a tea seller comes to their window and they starts taking tea. While taking tea, a conversation about tea goes on between them, in which Rajveer tells Pranjol that about 80 crore cup of tea are drunk every day throughout the world. Also, Rajveer tells a story about discovery of tea. So what is the story behind discovery of tea? So let us read out and come to know. So all of you are requested to take out your book and open it at page number 95. So turn your book to page number 95. Okay, so I hope you all are ready to begin. Third paragraph. I have been reading as much as I could about tea, Rajveer said. Rajveer said to Pranjol that he had been reading as much as he could about tea. He was very much curious to know about tea. So that is why before visiting Assam, he did some study regarding discovery of tea. He studied more about tea. No one really knows who discovered tea, but there are many legends. He said, Rajveer said, no one knows who discovered tea, but behind it there are many legends. So there are many legends behind discovery of tea. At this, Pranjol asked him, what legends? Well, there's the one about the Chinese emperor who always boiled water before drinking. Then Rajveer tells, one legend is about the Chinese emperor who always boiled water before drinking. The Chinese emperor, he used to boil water before drinking it. One day, a few leaves of twigs burning under the pot fell into the water, giving it a delicious flavor. One day, some leaves of burning twigs, some leaves of burning twigs fell into the water, and it gave him a delicious taste. It gave him a flavor. Okay. It gave him a delicious flavor. It is said they were tea leaves. So according to that tea legends, the leaves which fell into that boiling water, which was later drunk by that emperor, so it was said that those leaves were tea leaves. Tell me another, scoffed Pranzol. Now, scoffed means, you know, asked jokingly. So I told you yesterday, I made you write all the words and their meanings yesterday. Scoffed means asked jokingly. Pranjol asked jokingly, tell me another. So he said, tell me the another story. What is the another story behind, you know, discovery of tea? We have an Indian legend too. He said, we have, apart from a Chinese legend, we have an Indian legend too. Bodhidharma. What is Indian legend? Bodhidharma, an ancient Buddhist ascetic, cut off his eyelids because he felt sleepy during meditation. So he said, Bodhidharma, an ancient Buddhist monk. Okay. So ascetic means monk. An ancient Buddhist monk. His name was Bodhidharma. He cut off his eyelids because he felt sleepy during meditation. He was feeling, you know, sleepy during meditation. So that is why he cut off his eyelids. Ten tea plants grew out of the eyelids. So where he cut off his eyelids, at the same place, 10 tea plants grew up. The leaves of these plants were put in hot water and drunk, banished sleep. So it was said, the leaves of these plants, the leaves of these 10 plants which grew at the same place, where he cut off his eyelids, when they were put in hot water and drunk, it banished sleep. It get rid of sleep. It vanished sleep. So, you know, it is another story. It is a Indian legend behind discovery of tea. Tea was first drunk in China, Razvir added. Further, Razvir added that tea was first drunk in China. As far back as 2700 BC, and it was drunk in 2700 BC. In fact, words such as tea, chai and chini are from Chinese. Further, Rajveer said, words such as tea, chai and chini, they are the Chinese words. To came to Europe only in the 16th century, and tea came to Europe only in 16th century and was drunk more as medicine than a beverage. So it was drunk as medicine than a beverage. What is beverage? So anything which is meant for drinking, so that is beverage. Okay. That is called in Hindi, pay. which can be drunk. Okay. So, delicious drink, we can say beverage. Okay. So, more as medicine than a beverage. So, earlier in 16th century, when it came to Europe, then Europe in people, those days, people were drinking it as medicine, not as beverage. The train clattered into Mariani Junction. Now, train entered Mariani Junction. It is the name of a station. The boys collected their luggage and pushed their way to the crowded platform. The boys, because they had to get off at Mariani Junction, so that is why they made their way by pushing, because it was a crowded station. Okay, and they got off at Mariani Junction. Pranjol's parents were waiting for them. Pranjol's parents were waiting for Pranjol and Rajveer. Soon they were driving towards Dhekia Bari, the tea garden managed by Pranjol's father. And soon they were driving towards Dhekia Bari, which was the tea garden, and it was managed by Pranjol's father. An hour later, the car veered sharply off the main road. So, an hour later, the car took a sharp turn. Veered sharply off means took a sharp turn to the main road. They crossed the cattle bridge. So, from the main road, the car took a turn, and now they crossed a cattle bridge and entered Dhekia Bari tea state. So they had to go through a bridge that built over ditch, a cattle bridge, which was built over ditch. Okay, so they had to go through, they had to cross a cattle bridge and entered Dhekia Bari tea state. On both sides of the gravel road were acre upon acre of tea bushes. So on both side of the gravel road means, you know, the road which was that is called in Hindi pakki sadak, you can say. Okay, so on the both side of that gravel road were acre upon acre of tea bushes. So only tea bushes could be seen on both sides of the road. Groups of tea pluckers with bamboo baskets on their backs, wearing plastic aprons, were plucking the newly sprouted leaves. So groups of tea pluckers with bamboo baskets, you must have seen how you know, people in Assam, they pluck tea leaves. You must have seen on your TV. Okay, so and today there are so many sources where you can see how people pluck tea leaves. Okay, so a group of tea pluckers with bamboo baskets on their backs, wearing plastic aprons, were plucking the newly sprouted leaves. They were plucking the newly sprouted leaves of tree. Now turn your book to page number 96. Pranjol's father slowed down to allow a tractor pulling a trailer load of tea leaves to pass. Pranjol's father slowed down his car to allow a tractor pulling a trailer, which was pulling a trailer loaded with tea leaves. He allowed the tractor which was pulling a trailer, and trailer was loaded with the tea leaves. He allowed to pass. He allowed the tractor to pass. This is the second flush of sprouting period, isn't it, Mr. Barua? Rajveer asked to Pranjal's father. So this is the second flush or sprouting period. He said this is the second flush or second sprouting period, isn't it, Mr. Barua? So he confirmed Pranjal's father. It lasts from May to July and yields the best tea. Further, he added that it ends from May to July. So it starts from May and lasts to July. Okay, starts from May and continues till July and yields the best tea and grows the best tea. Who said it? Rajveer said it. You seem to have done your homework before coming, Pranjal's father said in surprise. So Pranjal's father said in surprise that it seems that you have done your homework before coming here. Yes, Mr. Barua. He said, yes, Mr. Barua, Rajveer admitted. But I hope to learn much more while I am here. And further, he added that he was hoping to learn much more while he was there in Assam. So, dear students, it is all about part 3, tea from Assam. So, let us recall what is the stories in all three parts. Okay. Part 1 of the story is a baker from Goa. A baker from Goa, in which we have seen that how a baker plays a very important role in Goa. In ancient time, bakers were more important than today. It doesn't mean today they have lost their importance. Still they are important, but not as they were in olden days. People of Goa, they still talk about the bakers. People of Goan village, they talk about bakers and their loaves of bread. Still, it is discussed, their loaves of bread still discussed among people of Goan village. The author tells us, bakers used to make loaves of bread, bread bangles, and bowling hearts. Author also tells us how when baker comes to his village, how children were pushed aside and loaves of bread were delivered to the servants of the house, and they were called Bestine and Peskine. Further, the author tells us how author as well as other children, they used to love bread bangles. They did not mind even brushing their teeth in order to eat bread bangles. The author also gives a very funny example, very funny statement for the same. He said, a tiger never brushes its teeth. So why we should? and who bother to pluck the mango leaves to brush the teeth. So it tells us that those days they were using mango leaves for brushing their teeth. So thus the narrator tells us the importance of a baker in Goan village. Still, they are equally important, but now they are remembered only on some special occasions. They are not famous as they were famous in those days when a narrator was a child. Narrator also tells that how in his childhood he remembers very well bakers used to come twice a day. First time when they went to sell their loaves of bread, bread bangles and bowling hearts, and second time when they came back after emptying their basket. They were not much educated. They used to write their accounts on the wall in pencil. The author tells us. The author also tells us how they were like a companion. They were like companions for narrator. So thus, in the first part of this chapter, a baker from Goa, the narrator tells us the importance of a baker in, especially in Goan villages. Okay. Then we have gone through second part of this chapter, which is Coorg. In this part of this chapter, the author tells us the importance of Coorg, how Coorg, famous for its rainforests, spices and coffee country. Further, the narrator also tells us this place Coorg is inhabited by martial men, beautiful women and wild creatures. How one can enjoy visiting Coorg? Even a lazy person becomes active. The author tells us Coorg is situated between Mangalore and coastal town of between Mangalore and Mysore. So between Mysore and coastal town of Mangalore, sorry. So the narrator tells us Coorg is situated between Mysore and coastal town of Mangalore, and the best time for visiting Coorg is from September to March, because it rains heavily in the rest of the months of the year. So a visitor, one can go to Coorg, one can visit Coorg from September to March. He also tells us the first general in army was a Coorgi. General Kariyappa was a Coorgi. One can enjoy the rappelling, mountain biking and many adventurous sports in Coorg. One can see many wild creatures. But here narrator tells us, the author tells us, he keeps a distance with wild animals. And one can see the monks in, they were with the ochre and yellow. They were in ochre and yellow cloth. So it would be like icing on the cake for the visitors. So there are so many things which a visitor can enjoy in Coorg. Now let us move on to third part, which we have just finished. It is about tea. Okay, so we have just finished part 3, which is about tea from Assam. So how tea gardens are there in Assam can be seen. So how tea is planted in Coorg, and how it yields two to three times a year. So all these things we have gone through, and what is the story, what are the stories behind discovery of tea. So we have gone through part 3. So it is all about chapter 7, Glimpses of India. Now let us go through question answers and other exercises. Thinking about language, look at these words: upkeep, downpour, undergo, drop out, walk in. They are built up from a verb: keep, pour, go, drop, walk, and an adverb or a particle: up, down, under, out, in. So use these words appropriately in the sentence below. In the sentences below, you may consult a dictionary. So you may use a dictionary, and you will have to fill these blanks which are given below. So if you have any doubt, you can let me know in online classes. Okay beta, so please, using dictionary, so first of all you should find out the meanings of these words, then fill all these blanks. Now fill in the blanks in the sentences given below by combining the verb given in the brackets with one of the words from the box as appropriate. Now you will have to choose the appropriate prepositions from the given below, and you have to fill these blanks. So go on and do all the grammatical exercises on your own. If you have any doubt, you can use dictionary. Even though you are confused, you have doubt, you can ask me in online classes. Okay, so notice how these ing and ed adjectives are used. Chess is an interesting game. I am very interested in chess. Going trekking in Himalayas this summer is an exciting. We are very excited about the trek. Are all your school books this boring? How he was bored as he had no friends there. So we have seen, students, how adjectives are made out of verbs, how verbs have been used as an adjective. So we know that, students, any word, if it tells us more about a noun or pronoun, it is called an adjective. So here we have seen that how some ing forms and ed forms of verb have been used as an adjective. So the ing adjectives show the qualities that chess, trekking, or these books have. They cause interest, excitement, or boredom in you. The ed, e, and adjectives show your mental state or your physical state. So how you feel in response to ideas, events, or thing. So now after going through these examples, think of suitable ing or ed adjectives to answer the following questions. You may also use words from those given above. So you can also use the words from those given above. You can think on your own adjectives for giving answer to these words. Okay, so it is very interesting exercise, and I want you all to think about more adjectives and do this exercise. Okay, so you must give time for doing this exercise. Okay, so must go through all grammatical exercises of this chapter. Now use the adjectives in the exercise above as appropriate to write a paragraph about Coorg, and you have to also write a paragraph about Coorg. Read the following passages about tea which has been taken from history, Tea Anytime by Ranjit Biswas from Literary Review, The Hindu, 1st October 2006. So what you have to do now after going through this paragraph, collect information about tea. Example, its evolution as a drink, its beneficial qualities. You can consult an encyclopedia or visit internet websites. Then form groups of five and play the following roles. Imagine a meeting of a tea planter, a sales agent, a tea lover, consumer, a physician, and a tea shop owner. Each person in the group has to put forward his or her views about tea. You may use the following words and phrases. This is very interesting exercise, beta, and it will be done in online classes. Okay, so very soon this exercise will be done in online classes. You are the sales executive of a famous tea company, and you have been asked to draft an advertisement for the product. Draft the advertisement using the information you collected for the role play. So you can draw pictures or add photographs and make your advertisement colorful. So you have to write make an advertisement of tea. So it's also very interesting. You will have to make it in your notebook, an advertisement of tea. Okay, so informations which you have collected or which you have discussed, you must mention. So it should be a creative advertisement. Okay, you can also draw simple sketches. Okay students, so it's all about this chapter. In my next class, I will start a new chapter. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. Bye bye and see you tomorrow.